It's on, brother.
It's good to be with you today. One day. One day. You're gonna die. One day you're gonna die. Muhammad died! Charles Darwin died! And Sigmund Freud died! One day you're gonna die! And when you die, it ain't the end! When you die, there's the day of judgment! You're either gonna be in hell or heaven! Why? I'll tell you why. Because evolution is a myth. Your mama and your papa did not come from an orangutan or an ape. You don't look like an ape and you don't walk like an ape. You didn't come from an ape. Anybody here look like an ape? No! My friends, you were not evolved. God created you.
Liar, liar.
Come and have a debate with me, sir. Don't call me a liar. One day you're gonna die. Jesus said this in John chapter 11.
I believe in that.
You wanna come and have a chat, bro?
No.
Come and have a chat with me.
You said one day you're gonna die. I said, yeah, I believe.
Come and have a chat with me.
There's nothing wrong with it, brother, isn't it?
Jesus said,
don't cut the trees, please.
Come and have a chat with me, bro. Are you gonna get me a kebab if I give you some money? Yeah, go and get me a kebab, bro.
Do you like the cross?
Yeah, go and get me a kebab. I fancy a kebab, bro.
I don't need kebab.
Why are you a Muslim, sir?
You need to get...
Why are you a Muslim? Why are you a Muslim?
Preaching Christianity.
Tell me why you're a Muslim.
Awesome.
We've got hope.
Awesome.
We want you to have hope, bro. We want you to have hope. Have you got a hope as a Muslim? If you die tonight, have you got a hope?
Don't worry about me.
Are your sins forgiven?
Don't worry about yourself.
Bro, if you died tonight,
John,
are your
John,
sins
how are you?
Forgiven if you died tonight?
Remember me.
If you died tonight, are your
long time ago with Sami, I was always with Sami.
Yeah. If you died tonight, are your
Sami,
sins
I was
forgiven?
And that. How are you?
What if he died
I heard
tonight?
He died,
Sami, if you died tonight, are your sins forgiven?
Yes, Sami,
you can know your sins. 1 John chapter 1 verse 9. If you confess your sin, he is faithful and just to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. You can know your sins forgiven.
How about you? The old sheikh that told me this.
Because Christ loved you and died.
Yes, Sami, the Moroccan guy.
The
old Moroccan Sami.
You've got no hope. If you died without him, you've got no hope, bro.
He went to Morocco, but he died there.
Because he died and rose again for you, bro.
He told me the brother.
He died for you, bro. Without Christ, you've got no hope.
I came last October. I saw you. I just passed you by because you were talking. I said hello.
He rose again.
I went and asked you, brother.
He said, I am the resurrection and the life. And he conquered death.
But you said he died.
And he gave you a hope if you believe in him.
Are you lying now?
I even, I lend you my ladder.
You die, you're lost. But if you trust Christ,
I went back to Switzerland.
Listen,
in 2007, 2008.
Who's got a hope?
I lived in Switzerland since then. And then
he doesn't know.
Like a couple of months ago, let me go and check, you know, Sami and the people I know.
I don't know who got a hope.
I decided to come back. So I came back last October.
We have a hope.
And that's what I saw you.
That if you confess your sin, God bless you, bro. If you confess your sin, he is faithful and just to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. There's no hope in atheism. There's no hope in Islam.
We have his video.
What hope is in Islam?
Thank you, I got it now.
What hope is there? Tell me what hope is there in Islam. Tell me, bro. Tell me! Tell me what hope is there in Islam? Tell me what hope is there in Islam?
Hope.
Tell me, come on! Tell me what hope is there in Islam?
Hope.
You die tonight as a Muslim. If you die tonight as a Muslim, do you know that your sins are forgiven? How do you know your sins are forgiven? Name me one Quran verse that tells you that your sins are forgiven and you get to glory.
Listen to this.
You had a big chance to do dawah on me and you failed. You had big chance, you nice Muslim. My friend, have you ever lied?
Yes.
Right? So the wrath of God is on you if you've lied. But He died on your behalf. Christ died on your behalf. He took your punishment. So if you believe in Him, come forward, you can talk. Right? I believe in the dead God. Come here, let me explain to you. He's saying I believe in the dead God. Let me explain to you. My dear brother, you're a dear brother, a nice man. In the beginning was the Quran.
Which beginning?
According to Muslims.
Which beginning?
In the beginning was the Quran. With God, is the Quran eternal? No. Many Muslims believe it's eternal. Yeah, don't wiggle out of this. Come on now, Muslim, come on. I love you guys, is it eternal? Yeah. Come on, freestyle me now. I ain't made it up, mate. I'll give you £20 if you can find out I ain't made it up. My friend, you know, do the Muslims believe the Quran is eternal? There we are, bro, that's two. I am making it up, bro. I love you too much to make it up. I like, have you seen this? I like this. I like the suit, you look nice in it. The Quran is eternal, it came down through Gabriel, then it went through Gabriel, and then it went through Muhammad, and then it went sticks and stones and bones, then it went to paper, and then from paper, the Quran was burnt by Uthman. Now, he says it in Bukhari. Now, if the Quran was burnt by Uthman, as people get to that, but if the Quran was burnt by Uthman, listen to me now, listen. It doesn't destroy what you believe to be the Word of God. Back to me. In the beginning was the Word, Jesus. Jesus became a man. If you destroy the man, does it destroy the Word? Don't destroy the Word. So you can't use that argument. Have you got a hope if you die tonight? If you died tonight, can you say your sins are forgiven? Can you say your sins are forgiven? I can. Can you say your sins are forgiven, brother?
Yes.
Can you say your sins are forgiven?
Let me finish.
1 John chapter 1 verse 9. If you confess your sins, He is faithful and just to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Now you give me a verse from the Quran. You hit me with the Quran now. Come on now. Come on, hit me with the Quran. Are you ready now? The Bible says, are you ready?
Yeah.
Are you ready? If you confess your sins, 1 John chapter 1 verse 9, if you confess your sin, he is faithful and just to cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Now you hit me with a Quran. You hit me with a verse that can equal the power of the word of God. You hit me with the word of the Quran that can equal the power of God that says that your sins can be forgiven by the blood of Jesus. Come on now.
What's the point of confessing your sin while you're still breaching the most important commandment? You're breaching the first commandment, right? You worship creation.
My friend, we're talking. My friend, you're talking about a situation where you need hope. My friend, my sister, you and I need hope. You need hope. And the only hope that you can have is Christ. The only hope that you can have is Christ. We can argue all day. We can argue all day. But if you die tonight, arguments are not going to help you if you die tonight. If you die tonight, arguments aren't going to help you. It's only the blood of the Lamb that will help you. It's only the blood of the Lamb.
I'm asking about the company
to the church. In Mark chapter 10, Jesus said, I give my life a ransom. He said, I am the good shepherd.
Yes.
So Jesus came to die. Wait a minute, my friend. He came to die for you.
Yes, sir.
If you don't have Christ, you have no hope.
Amen.
What hope have you got in Islam? Tell me. What is your hope in Islam?
God is no hope.
Okay, are you forgiven right now? Where does it say in the Quran? Where does it say in the Quran? You had the opportunity. The only hope that you have is the blood of Christ, my friend. That is the only hope. The blood was shed for you. The blood was given for you. Muhammad did not die for you. What did Muhammad do for you? What? What did Muhammad do for you? What did he do? How come Muhammad said in the Quran you can only have four wives, but he had more than four wives? He says you can have four wives, but he had more than four wives. So what did Muhammad do for you? What did Muhammad do for you? Let me explain to you. We have a hope because it's based on a pure Savior, a pure Lord Jesus who loved us and guided us. He wasn't twisting and lying. He wasn't messing around. He loved us and died for us. But Muhammad did not love you. He did not love you. Muhammad said in the Quran, he said, Zaheed. He said, Zaheed. Zaheed's wife. I can marry. Who was Zaheed? Zaheed was the wife of the adopted son of Muhammad. Zaheed was the adopted son of Muhammad. Who did Muhammad marry? Married his wife. My friend, it doesn't make sense, bro. It doesn't make sense. My friend, it doesn't make sense.
And I have a adopted son. Yeah? It's up there, but the adopted son, he takes
Okay, let's look at this in logical, right? Logical, right? Jesus was pure and he died for us, he loved us and he died for us, right? A guy comes along and says to the prophet, he fancies his adopted son's wife, he fancies her, and then comes up with a scripture to say that he can marry the wife. And guess what? In the verse before it, it says we're not to have adopted sons, but it says before that, that he could marry his adopted son's wife. So there's logical contradictions. Listen, it says he can marry his adopted son's wife, but then it says we're not to have adopted sons. It's illogical. It's illogical. Go get your apologies. Did you know? Listen. Did you know your apologies won't debate me? They won't debate me. You know why they won't debate me? I'll tell you why they won't debate me. See there? I've got Hadith, I've got Arabic ready for them, so they're not willing to debate me. No, they don't want to debate because we're ready for them. We're ready for them. I'll explain to you. Let me explain. Isaiah 53, 600 years before Jesus. Listen, if you died tonight, have you got a hope? I'll go home right now and never come to Hyde Park. If you can stand here right now and tell me you have got 100% hope.
Of what?
Eternal life.
Eternal life.
We have 100% hope. We have 100% hope. Because it's not based on us, it's based on Jesus who loved you. It's based on the love of God that gave his life for you. It's based on Christ, my friend. It's real, my friend. It's based on him. It's not based on me. It's based on him. It's not based on the church. It's based on Jesus. We have 100% hope in Christ. We don't have 100% hope. Show me a Quran verse. Show me a verse. You got 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You made that up, no? I could go. Shihana Buli, Gili, Bili, Bili. Make it up. Jesus loved you and died for you, bro. He gave his life for you. You shed his blood and you need Christ. You need to believe in him. No, you've got no hope. What hope have you got? You've got no hope, bro. You need Christ, my friend. You need Christ in your life. Are you a Muslim? Have you got a hope? If you died tonight, have you got a hope? If you died tonight, have you got a hope? If you died tonight, have you got a hope? I'll go to Manchester and never come back here. If you can tell me right now, you've got 100% hope. You ain't got 100% hope. The 100% hope is in Christ. It's in the Son of God. It's in the King of Kings. It's in the one who loved you and died for you. That is the hope, my friend. I love you. I love you. I love you. And he loved you and he died for you. He loved you. He died for you, my friend. He loved you. So get right with him. Let me ask you something. Have you ever lied? Have you ever lied? Yes. Have you ever stolen? Have you ever looked at a woman in lust? Right. Now, the wrath of God, if you died tonight, would be upon you. If you've lied, stolen, and committed adultery in your heart, and if you died tonight, the wrath of God will be upon you.
some.
You can have it on the basis of what Jesus has done, that Jesus loved you and died. You remember John the Baptist? What did he say? When John the Baptist saw Jesus, did he say this? Behold, Muhammad! Behold, the Hadith! Behold the Quran! Behold the Kaaba! What did he say? He said this. Behold the love of God that takes away the sin of the world, my friend. Oh, my friend, he loves you so much. He loves you so much. He loves you so much. I feel you could be in heaven dancing together, bro. And I reckon you're a good dancer. From the Bible, yes. Can God be defeated?
No.
So, if God gives a word, can his word be defeated?
No.
End of debate. It's no good saying the Quran can't change. If God has given a word and he gave the Bible, God cannot be defeated.
John,
the Quran has changed. Yeah. The Quran has changed. God bless you, Bob. The Quran has changed. Have you heard in the half of the Quran?
What is it?
The Quran used by most Muslims, Sunni Muslims, that is what is called the half Quran and the was Quran. Now the half Quran, there are textual variants that are not the same as the was Quran. This is Arabic. No. In the half Quran, it often uses you. In the Wash Quran and the Duri Quran, it often uses we, the magisterial we, right? So, when you compare the verses, they are not the same. Is it the same when I say we cross the road, you cross the road? Are they the same?
The
Wash Quran often says we, the Hash Quran often says you in the same verse. They're not the same in the other way. He is known as a liar in Hadith scholarship. Bukhari says that he is a liar.
You don't tell
Bukhari is the most authoritative Hadith collector, and he says that half is a liar and half is behind the Quran that you use today.
But in Saudi Arabia,
so your Quran not only has been changed, it's been massacred, bro. I'm not sure. 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 I'm not sure say.
I am
all I'm saying today is it's about hope. What hope is if a man came here right now and put a shotgun to my head and said you were never to preach again, I would keep preaching. And as he pulled that trigger and blew my head off, I have hope. Do you know why I have hope? I was just saying, do you know why I have hope? Because of Jesus Christ has saved.
It's not because of our religion, it's
because of
our customs.
I'm just talking about the heart. I'm just talking about the heart. The main Quran, that the Muslims use today is the heart. The Half Quran, a guy called Half. He was a narrator. Now when you investigate Half,